So first things first, NARS Audacious lipsticks. Oh my gosh, mind blowing. I really like that they're magnetic and you can actually line them up and it'll spell. I only have three to show you, so I can't spell out all of NARS, but they're magnetic. They do actually stick together. I don't want to drop them. They don't hold together that well, but that's just talking about the packaging. The formula is insane. So the one I'm wearing right now is, this is not the one I'm wearing right now. This is the one I'm wearing right now. This is Raquel. It is hands down one of my favorite lipsticks ever from the first time I wore it. Unfortunately, there's not a whole lot in that bullet. It takes me forever to use up lipsticks though, because I have so many. third world problems. But like when I swatched it, I was kind of hesitant because it looks kind of scary, but just in terms of pigmentation. But when I put it on, it goes on a little bit lighter than it does in the swatch. But it's like completely opaque, full pigment, and it does not feel dry at all. It's not super glossy, but it's not completely matte. It feels really good on the lips, and it wears super well. I don't get the lip lines. It wears down nicely. It doesn't stain. Next is Barbara. This is more of a brown tone nude. I'm gonna swatch up my hand and then I'm gonna do a lip swatch. Okay. Okay, so Barbara. Amazing. I'm obsessed with this one too. The Raquel and Barbara, the two of them have been pretty much all I've worn since I've got them. Even though I have other lipsticks that I loved this month, I just cannot stop wearing these two. They just go with everything. They're just effortless. They are super pretty. Like I said, the formula with this one too, the formula is just the same, how it wears. So there's that. I'm nervous to swatch this one because it might stain a little bit. But this is the other one that I have, which is also freaking stunning. This is Charlotte. So pretty. So Charlotte swatches a bit more berry. And like, see, look at how it looks in the tube. It looks more burgundy, right? And I'm going to put it on and show you. So it looks a little bit berry at first, but when you... Oh my god, I just love these so much. I've actually seen some... Oops. Some stick on my face, that's always good. Some bad reviews of Charlotte. Just saying that, you know, it's not as effortless in application as these other shades. But, I mean, look how pigmented it is. No wonder it's hard. But look how freaking gorgeous that is. Like, I just can't with these lipsticks. They're, look at that. Holy crap. Oh my god. They're stunning. Definitely some of the best lipsticks I've ever tried. I think the shade range is great. I've heard some people say that they're not that impressed with the shade range, but swatch them and see if you change your mind, because even shades that I thought I wasn't going to be interested, like Anna I tried on yesterday, it's stunning, and that one's the next one on my list now. I never thought I would like that. It's kind of purpley toned, mauve. I never go for those, but just looking at myself on camera right now, I like can't take my eyes off my lipstick. But these are just amazing. I think they're awesome. Definitely check out the NARS Audacious lipsticks. They are worth the price. That is like the thing that's been bothering me the most, is people are like, oh, is it worth the price? You know, Chanel lipsticks, YSL lipsticks, they're all the same price as these ones, and these ones are just as good as those. So why should they be cheaper? The packaging is clearly, I mean, they've got the snap magnetic closure. The packaging's nicer. They, you know, they have the embossing of the logo. Obviously, there's some extra effort in there. The formula. There's just no, I can't think of a single dupe for this formula. Or for the shades, to be honest, because the formula's unique. So, worth it for me, for sure. So, let's get this beast off my lips and swatch some more lipsticks for you. Be right back. Okay, so it didn't stain my lips too badly. And the next one I'm going to show you, I'll just show you another red tone. Anyways, so I've been wearing this one a lot as well when I've been wanting to go kind of bolder. This is the Burberry Lip Velvet in the shade 312 Hawthorne Berry. I'm not really a big fan of Burberry lipsticks usually because I don't like the scent. Sorry, the lighting is getting a little weird in here. But the packaging is really nice. Again, it's like the NARS with the... They actually look similar to NARS next to each other. But this is a little bit more of a matte packaging. So this is Burberry, this is NARS. But this color is gorgeous. I'm loving like brownie reds right now. And this is definitely a nice formula. You can get past the scent. I recommend checking these out. I'm fortunate enough to have Nordstrom that carries Burberry. And also someone was telling me recently that they sell Burberry makeup in the Burberry store on Michigan Avenue too. So I was not aware because I've never been in the Burberry store. But yeah, super pretty. I love the combination of this with this lipstick. I need to swatch it. I didn't swatch it. So that's Hawthorne Berry. I love that this lip with this on the eyes. It's like leaves changing color. I'm so basic. Oh my god, I hate that word. Can I just say? This is what's like, these are the things that make me feel like I'm getting older. It's like stuff like the word basic. I just want to strangle myself when I hear people say that word. I'm like, what does it even mean? I literally had to Google it and look it up on Urban Dictionary because I didn't get it. Does that make me basic? I don't know, but I hate that word. Don't use it around me or I will punch you. So, okay, so that's Burberry Hawthorne Berry gorgeousness. This is totally going to be a second video. I have too many lipsticks to show you. Next, this one is from Estee Lauder. It's one of the Color Envy lipsticks. These are a great formula. Unfortunately, a lot of the shades just didn't really catch my eye. These are super opaque also, and they're kind of creamy. This is in the shade Discreet. It was released for fall. And I love this because it's just so easy. These smell so like, not smell, but they taste so good. They taste like butterscotch and vanilla or something. They taste amazing. And these ones, magnetic too. I don't think the packaging doesn't really appeal to me though. It's like navy and it's kind of old lady. But this formula is amazing. This color is super easy to wear. And it's just a nice kind of, oh, I need to swatch this. Jessica, you're slacking today. So it's just a really easy kind of mauvey brown. Yeah, I just love this. It's been a handbag staple. So, yes, love that. I cannot not mention my beloveds, these Bite lip, what are they even called? I'm blinking. The matte lip crayons. Oh my god. I was like, I had a serious problem this month with these, but the two that I've worn the most are definitely Cognac, which is really scary when you swatch it. It's a very deep brown, but how I like wearing this is either as a stain, just like kind of blotted in and blended, or blended over a nude lipstick. Like MAC Honey Love is probably my favorite one to do that with. Also the Hourglass... Femme Rouge, is that what they're called? The lip crayons that Hourglass do. They look great over those too. Then my favorite one to just wear on its own is Amaretto, which I don't think I've swatched in a video before, so I'm going to do that now. I'm not going to do Cognac because it's just too much. I don't wear it on its own anyways. So that is Amaretto. Total Kylie Jenner. It's Kylie, right? Yeah. Kylie Jenner. I don't really pay attention to the Kardashians, but I do pay attention to Kylie Jenner's makeup because her makeup's amazing. So definitely Kylie Jenner lip. It's probably my favorite one for that kind of look, but I've been wearing this a ton. That Amaretto and the NARS lips, the three NARS lipsticks, are definitely like my favorite of favorites this month. Also, I busted this out. I got this over the summer. In the beginning of the summer, I think. But, wow, it's showing up, like, super neon. It actually looks kind of neon in the tube, too, really. But this is the Burberry Lip Glow Balm in Orange Poppy. I really actually like this on days when I'm not wearing a lot of makeup. Most of these lipsticks I have swatches of on Instagram, too. But I just felt like it might be fun to do it in a video. But this is just really a nice, like, effortless lipstick for when you want kind of a punch of color but not too much. Yeah, the scent doesn't bother me as much with that one as other Burberry lipsticks either. So it feels really moisturizing. Like I said, it's just effortless, especially when I just feel it feels like a mascara lipstick blush kind of day where I don't feel like wearing anything else. Yeah, really like that. So next, oh my god, there's so much. Definitely second, this is gonna be a second video for sure. So Maybelline came out with these new creamy matte lipsticks, and they're amazing. I wasn't sure how good they were gonna be, but they actually, the formula is super nice. They feel really soft and smooth, and they're very pigmented. So this is a Nude Embrace. Sorry, the sun is coming out very brightly. So Nude Embrace, maybe if I put it closer to my face. Why do I always have this problem in videos, because I feel like I'm always getting ready at the same time of day when I have a day off. So Nude Embrace, very pretty. My face still looks true to color. That's the important thing, right? I'm getting tissue on my face. This one is Daringly Nude. Some of these have these weird, I've noticed this with other Maybelline lipsticks, they have these weird, like, air bubbles. I don't know if you can see them. There's little air bubbles. Oh, Givenchy. Why am I questioning myself? The La Rouge lipsticks do that, too. I was going to say, I know I've seen another lipstick do that. But, hey, that is not a bad thing, because those are, like, my favorite matte formula of lipsticks ever, is the Givenchy La Rouge. So there is a swatch of Daringly Nude. This one is just has a little bit more pink in it, the Nude Embrace. Both of these, though, are awesome colors. Formulas are really good. I've worn these on long days at work before, and they wore really well. They didn't make lip lines. They just kind of faded nicely. This one is Touch of Spice. I didn't get any of the, like, brights, but I like these ones so much that I definitely am thinking about checking those out now, too. So that's Touch of Spice at the end. These are just so great for a drugstore lipstick. I can't get over them. The only reason I haven't worn them more is because I can't stop wearing the NARS Audacious ones, but these are definitely amazing, and possibly my favorite ever Maybelline lipstick release, aside from the Color Whispers, which I love too. But they're kind of, you know, they're different things. But these are really, really good. I wish that the buffs had come out in that formula too. You know what's funny? I was going to bring water over and I was like, oh, I won't need water. I totally do. Next. This is really like 2 months worth of favorites, by the way, because I haven't done a favorites video in a while. These NYX Simply Nude lip crayons, or I guess they're called lip creams. They're really lip crayons. I don't know what they're trying to say. I love these. They have 4 different collections. One is Simply Pink, one is Simply Vamp, Simply Nude, obviously, and Simply Reds. I was too infatuated with this collection to do any of the other ones, but I swatched all of them, if you can believe it. I probably looked crazy. But there are definitely some nice shades in all the ranges. So this one is number 4, Fairest. This one's a little bit on the chalky side. Sorry, I feel like maybe I need to fix, because this is really blinding down there. Let me fix my blinds real quick. I'll be right back. Okay, that's a little bit better. It's a little bit shady looking, but actually I feel like this lighting is really good. Maybe I should do this more often. So this is a little bit chalky, and I feel like it works best when you kind of blend it with your finger. I haven't tried wearing this one all day yet because it kind of makes me nervous. I feel like it's not going to wear well throughout the day, but I really like the color, and I just wanted to show you that one because I want to show you the other two as well. But that's probably my least favorite of the three that I got. Need to show this hairspray I've been using as a non-favorite. It's a Pantene one, and I feel like it makes my hair look really frizzy, and it doesn't, like, it comes out of my hair. I feel like my hair's not even holding. What's going on? So this is number 2, and since I'm done putting it on, I'll tell you what the name of the shade is. The name of this one is Exposed. So there's Fairest, there's Exposed. So there's Exposed on. This one is kind of, the crayon is actually loose, and it's like actually like come apart at the base. So I have to be really careful with this one. But I love the color of this. This one feels really good on the lips, and I feel like this one would wear really well throughout the day, even though I haven't tried doing it yet. I've just swatched it. I haven't really had these that long. And then last but not least, this is number 6, which is Sable. So that Sable is the darkest one in the end. Yeah, I feel like a lot of different skin tones would like this lipstick too, because it's just kind of a universally flattering shade. So, very nice. And then last but not least, Bobbi Brown Creamy Matte Lip Colors. I love the Bobbi Brown Creamy Matte Lip Colors just in general. I talk a lot of smack about the regular lip colors, the ones that have the pointed, the normal shape lipstick bullet, because they taste awful, even though they have some really pretty colors, so I don't always recommend those. But the creamy mattes don't have that taste, that awful cheap taste that I hate. These ones taste more like vanilla, and these are just really like crazy pigmented. So the first one I will show you is Warm Nude. I get them confused because I feel like Warm Nude and Soft Nude, their names should be reversed. So this is Warm Nude, right? Yeah. And I think Warm Nude is a little bit similar to Maybelline Nude Embrace. I'm actually gonna... So that's Warm Nude. I'm gonna show you Nude Embrace next to it, actually, so you can see. It's a little, a little bit more mauve. But I think, like, they're not exactly the same by any means. You can see that Warm Nude has more of a rose tone. But they look kind of similar on, so if you want to save some money, I would just get the Maybelline one, because that formula is really nice also. but I just wanted to show you these because I love them too. This one is Soft Nude, which I said I feel like they should be swapped. And if you're checking out this shade range anyway, definitely check out Crushed Plum, which is one of my absolute favorite colors for fall. I didn't bring that one out to show you, but I love it. So that is Soft Nude, which I feel like it's darker than Warm Nude, so why is it called soft? I could go on about this forever. Oh, let me swatch it for you too. So that is Soft Nude. Next, Pink Nude. This is one that I don't think I would have even gravitated towards until I swatched it. And then I was like, I actually like that. It's kind of different. So that's Pink Nude. I don't really have a lot of shades like this. It was definitely kind of a Pokemon, gotta catch them all type of thing with these lipsticks. and then this one is Nude, which this one is probably the one I feel like most people would obsess over. Because again, it's that Kylie Jenner lip. So that is Nude On. I feel like Nude also is a little bit, I wanted to see, because I feel like it's a little bit similar to Barbara. It is a little bit similar. So that is Nude and that is Barbara. So it's your call, guys. I would choose Barbara over the two just because I feel like, I said, I can't go on enough about this formula. But if you're on a budget and want to and are more interested in just getting the color without maybe the formula, then I would say you'd be fine with Bobbi Brown Nude, because the formula of these, like I said, is very nice also. So I know my friend Tiffany just got this lipstick also and it looks amazing on her. So I think that's it, guys. Oh my god, we made it through. So I think I'm gonna have this be a separate video, and I will probably call it the last 2 months in lipsticks. I actually might call it that because that's really what it is. But I hope that you enjoyed both of my favorites videos this month. It's been a fun ride. It's also my birthday month, so this is a weird month because I'm turning the age that my mom was when she gave birth to me. So I'm starting to feel weird about that. But anyways, oh, and these aren't favorites, but how amazing are, like, they're not favorites because I just got them, so I can't say they're my monthly favorites, but how amazing are these Rifle Paper Company Puffin and Bloom books? So I say Anna Rifle, like, she's the whole company, but she did do the art. So Rifle Paper Company did these covers and like inlays for classic books. They didn't do any illustrations on the inside, which I wish that they would have, because that would have been super amazing. But I got the little A Little Princess and Little Women. I want to get the other two as well, which are Heidi and Anne of Green Gables, but of the four, these are my two favorite books, so I wanted to get these first. They were like $10 each on Amazon. I can't believe how cheap they were. So I'm really excited about that little early birthday present for myself. Anyways, yeah, I'm gonna end this because it's forever long. So I will talk to you guys later. Love you. Bye.